So oraz umacnia was przez sakrament małżeństwa, abyście byli sobie zawsze wierni i umieli podjąć wybrane obowiązki małżeńskie. Razem z wami będziemy słuchać słowa Bożego i wspierać was naszymi modlitwami.
Teraz powiem. Father, who made the bond of marriage a holy mystery, a symbol of Christ's love for his church, hear our prayers for Patricia and Emma, the faith in you and in each other they pledge their love to them. May their lives always burn in peace for the reality of their love. We ask this through Jesus Christ our Lord, who is the Lord forever and ever. Please be seated.
Without love, I am simply a garment
am knowing everything, and if I have faith in all its fullness to move mountains, but without love, then I am nothing at all. If I give away all that I possess, piece by piece, and if I even let them take my body to burn, but I am without love, it will do me no good whatever. Love is always patient and kind. It is never jealous. Love is never boastful or conceited. It is never rude or selfish. It does not take offense. It is not resentful. Love takes no pleasure in other people's sins, but delights in the truth. It is always ready to excuse, to trust, to hope, and to endure whatever comes. Love does not come to an end. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Very carefully. there are differences, let them have respect. Where there are problems, let them be open. Grant that Patricia and Eric may not so much seek their own solution, but the best solution. For it is in listening that they hear, it is in hearing that they understand, and it is in understanding that they grow in love and commitment, and mostly in fidelity. God bless you and all the best, all of us. You have come together in the church of the Lord, may seal and strengthen the body of the presence of the church's ministry and ministers and his love. As a husband to be blessed with this love, he has already consecrated you in baptism, and now he reaches and strengthens you by a special sacrament of the Lord, the duties of marriage and mutual and husband and fidelity. And so, in your presence, I ask you to state your intentions. Patricia and Eric, have you come here freely and without reservation to give yourself to each other in marriage?
Yes.
Will you love and honor each other as men and as wife for the rest of your lives?
Yes.
Will you accept children loving from God and bring them up according to the law of Christ? Since it is your intention to enter into marriage, ask to please join your right hands and declare your consent before God and this holy church. I have
thank you, Patricia, to be my wife. I promise to be true to you and your son, and amen. In sinners and male, I will love you and honor you all the day of my life.
I, Patricia, take you, Eric, to be my husband. I promise to be true to you in good times and in bad, in sickness and health. I will love you and honor you all the days of my life.
My friends, you have declared your consent before church. For me, the Lord, remember, God has joined, no one must be loved. Lord, we ask you to bless and consecrate Patricia and Eric in the love for each other. May these rings be a symbol of truth, faith in each other, and always remind them of their love. We ask this through Christ.
Patricia, take this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
We pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. Father, you have chosen us and given us your love, the power of the Holy Spirit in our midst. Hear our prayers today and keep us open. May our faith issue forth in action. Our love show itself in deeds, and our hope give us courage. We ask this through Christ.
Promises made will strengthen us all, our world. Therefore, Together with Francis, I call and John Joseph, I initial and hold the clergy. Be mindful also, Lord, of Patricia and Eric, whom you have called to their wedding day, so they, by your grace, they may invite me to all love and peace. Remember also my brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the dawn of the resurrection, and all of whom have died. Welcome then to the light of your faith. Have mercy on us, we pray, that the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, to St. Joseph and spouse, of the Blessed Apostles, of St. Hedwig, our patroness, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, and Mary, to be conversed with eternal love, and may praise and glorify you through your Son. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I give you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will. We live and pray for ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Now let us hope and trust in the sacrament of God's peace.
Się łączą ręce w imię Boże. The afflicted and the needy will find you generous friends and welcome you in
Love and serve them, and full of